Hello everybody, welcome to my workshop. In this video I'll be showing you how to make coffee using homemade hydrogen and an aeropress brewer. I hope you will enjoy what you're about to see. Basically, in this video we'll be attempting to create hydrogen from a solution of sodium hydroxide and aluminum scraps. It is a well-known fact that aluminum reacts with water, however this reaction is only theoretical. The problem is, any piece of aluminum that can be found around the house or in the laboratory is covered by a thin layer of aluminum oxide, which prevents any reaction with the outside environment, including water. To counter this, we're gonna use the sodium hydroxide to break the aluminum oxide layer and hopefully initiate a very energetic reaction. The products of these reactions are hydrogen, the gas we are seeking to produce, and aluminum hydroxide, which is an inert and harmless compound. As you can see, I've already begun my experiment. First I created some sodium hydroxide solution, and now I'm inserting scraps of aluminum into my main reaction jar. I'm wearing hand and eye protection because sodium hydroxide is also known as caustic soda and is very dangerous to the skin and eyes. I am trying to get as much material into the jar without spilling over. The key here is to have as much surface area, to have as much aluminum reacting with the solution. This should do it. I don't want to get any of the sodium hydroxide solution spilling over. Here is a close-up of the jar. As you may observe, the bubbles have already started to form. Now that I get the reaction going, it's time to assemble the rest of my device. You can see how it works in this very crude diagram I've made. First, you have the main jar, the one you've already seen. Then the hydrogen bubbles, the gas that is produced, travels to a second jar, which acts as a bubbler. Here you can actually visualize the output of the hydrogen, and it also acts as a safety device, preventing the flashback, in case of an explosion, to go back to the main jar. And last, you have a one-way valve that is connected to a Bunsen burner, a type of burner that is used in chemical laboratories. The one-way valve acts as a main protection device in case you have an explosion or a small flash. It will hopefully prevent hydrogen going back to the bubbler and the rest of the setup. For visualization purposes and for the sake of a quick experiment, I'm using clear PVC hoses. However, this material is less than ideal for hydrogen experiments because the hydrogen molecule, being so small, can easily pass through the PVC hose. In fact, the hydrogen molecule can pass through many materials, and when making a permanent hydrogen installation, you have to choose your materials very carefully. This is a close-up view of the bubbler. As you may see, hydrogen bubbles are clearly forming. Now it's time to connect the Bunsen burner and the one-way valve. With these pieces in place, our setup should be complete. Close to 15 minutes later, it's time to attempt the ignition of the burner. By the way, you can check the real time of the experiment on the chicken clock. At first, ignition is unsuccessful. The rate of hydrogen production is quite low, and there is not enough gas to successfully ignite it. As time will go on, and as the reaction jar will heat up, more gas will be produced, and eventually we'll be able to ignite it and do something useful with it. Oh wait, it would appear that we have a small flame inside the burner. Let's get a closer look. For the moment the flame is quite small, but it will get bigger as the gas flow will increase. 5 minutes later, we have a second attempt. This time the flame is above the burner, and we can actually start brewing something. A close-up view of the flame. It's not much to look at, but I can assure you it will get bigger. Next, it's time to finally start boiling water. Here is another overview of the setup. As you can see, everything works nicely and the flame is slowly starting to heat up the water. I've decided to bring in an infrared thermometer and check the temperature of the main components. The main reaction jar has a slight increase in temperature. Currently it's at 31 degrees centigrade. This is a small but important detail of my construction. This is an upwards bend, so any part of the solution that gets splashed into the hose travels back into the jar. 32 minutes later, the temperature of the kettle is almost 90 degrees centigrade. Nobody said this will be a quick process. The sodium hydroxide jar is at 41 degrees centigrade. Another 10 minutes later, you can see the water boiling. It's time to lift off the kettle and make our coffee. To my surprise, I find out that the flame has gotten quite big. Its yellow color indicates a rich hydrogen mixture. I've decided to disconnect the bubbler and offer you a view from another angle. So this is the previous scene, as seen from my secondary camera. Next, I am going to put the bubbler away and then put the water into the AeroPress brewer. Sorry about that. Next, I put in the coffee grounds. Afterwards, I'm gonna continue pouring water and stir everything for a little while. Time to put the filter into the filter holder. By the way, this filter is homemade, as I ran out of original AeroPress ones. As the coffee grounds settle, I disconnect the bubbler and I'm gonna take the main jar somewhere safe. There I'm gonna open the top cap and pour all the sodium hydroxide solution into a chemical resistant container, thus stopping the reaction. Time to install the filter. By the way, I do apologize about the mess. It's time to squeeze the brew out of the AeroPress. The overspill is caused by not using the original filter. Sorry about that. Maybe using a mocha pot next time. So this is how you make coffee using science. I hope you enjoyed the video. Bye bye.